Okay, welcome to our last video in this series. And in this one, we're going to do an example where we do a diverging lens diagram. So this is going to be a scale diagram with a diverging lens. So the first thing I need to do is just set up my diagram. So I'm going to have my lens going in this direction and my principal axis in the other direction. They should be 90 degrees. And I'm going to give the end of my lens the diverging thicker end. So it says, hello, I am diverging and not converging. So there we go. Give it its nice triangular ends. Okay, ready to go. Then I just need to put on all of my stuff for my diagram. It says that the focal length is 6 centimeters. So I'm going to line up my ruler and I can draw on my 2 focal points, right? So I can put a focal point on one side and then the focal point on the other side. Excellent. So those are my focal points. And then it tells me that I need to do 4 centimeters from the lens. I'm going to make my object and it's going to be 1 centimeter tall. So all I'm doing right now is just I'm going to mark where the 4 centimeters are. So that's where I'll put my object. And then I can rotate my rotate this so that I can put my 1 centimeter, right? I can measure that out properly and put on my object. So there we go. This is going to be my object right here. Now I have my diagram. I can add my 3 lines very easily. Remember, this is diverging, so make sure you add the right lines. So my first line is going through the top of the object, and then instead of going down, remember, it's going to line up with this one back here. So I'm going to use my ruler to do that. So that will help me. So I need to rotate my ruler, obviously. So we're totally on the wrong angle. There we go. Come on, keep rotating, my friend. So I need to line up with this and line up with this. So I'm going to go through this and then line up with here. So there's line number 1. No problema. And then we will need to put line number 2 on. So line number 2, remember, we are going to go so that we're aiming at the other focal point on the other side. So we're aiming at this focal point, and then we will go straight. So we're going to just aim at this focal point. This is a bit of a fussy ruler, I admit. It's not a perfect system, this smart board gig, but hey, it is what it is. So rule number 2, we're going to aim at our secondary focal point. We're going to stop though, and then we're going to go straight. So we're parallel with our primary axis. And then finally, we can do our third one. So, and our third one is the same for all lovely lenses. Thank goodness. Super easy through the top of the object and straight on through. Now, this is virtual. That shouldn't be a surprise. We knew it was going to be virtual. So we need to trace those back. So we're going to trace them back and see where they cross, because that's what your brain is doing, right? Your brain is tracing them back to see where they cross. So this one's going to go back to see where it crosses. And then we're going to trace this one back to see where it crosses. Remember, the third one, you don't really need to trace back because it's just going to naturally meet. And then we can draw in our image. Don't forget to draw in our image. A lot of people forget this step. You should draw in your image so you can see it. There's my image right there. And now I can describe it quite easily because it is definitely, size-wise, it's smaller. It is definitely has an attitude of upright because it's right side up. It's a location. Well, it is definitely closer or behind. And finally, we can say that its type is virtual. And there we go. An example done.